My name is Imke Lüders. I'm a veterinary scientist and I'm coming from Germany, and I've about 6 years experience in reproduction and about 10 years of wildlife medicine background. And my primarily focus is on the reproduction of zoo and wild animals. And I work all over Europe in different zoos, and I come to Asia and Africa for field work. This is now the fourth year that we come to Ukutula for research projects. Ukutula has a state-of-the-art facility for lion breeding, and our primary aim is to look at the reproduction of lions. And this is a very convenient place for us because these animals are very used to humans and very used to handling, so there's minimal stress involved when we look at these animals. And we just got all the support that we needed here to do our research. We are actually studying the reproduction of the lions here, and it's primarily the male reproductive system because we want to find the best method to collect the sperm sample and to preserve these samples. So we're going to actually freeze sperm to create a sperm bank for these animals. And it's also to learn about big cat reproduction in general. So the lion can be a model species for other endangered cat species. Everything that we learned here so far has already contributed big time to conservation, because we have already produced actually offspring of highly endangered Persian leopards and Asiatic golden cats using the method that we studied here. And these offspring actually will go back to release projects in Russia. So the Persian leopards will be actually released and repopulate the habitats that they used to live in. That we are seeing a shrinking gene pool in wild animals because there was a lot of hunting, the habitats were shrinking. And so what we're doing now by creating a gene bank, we are actually creating a backup of genetic material to actually preserve the genetic diversity of the lion. So actually for all our projects, we have to go through ethical committees. They strictly review what we are doing, what our approaches are, and we got this ethical clearance here in South Africa for our projects, and we also got it for the German side. And it's a governmental, really strict reviewing committee, and they declared our research as minimal invasive. So what we actually do has only a small impact on the animal, if at all. We're just using one anesthesia and one animal at a time, and we always combine it with other procedures. Our research actually is all for the application purposes. So what we do in the end is we will actually use all our information to create protocols for artificial insemination of endangered species. And this is what we have done so far. So all that I learned here, I could put directly into practice in the zoos in Europe. And we have created offspring that actually will go to their wild habitats back again. So this is not just for the sake of research, it is actually for a practical approach to have an application to be able to produce offspring and to have all the methods at hand should these animals really decline so badly that we only can use something like artificial insemination to reproduce them in the future. And this is also what the sperm bank is for, to create a backup of genetic material. So this is actually it has no question just for why is it, but it is also a question of how can we develop the techniques and put them directly into practice to preserve and to protect the animals.